come on. It doesn't look like the horse moved on to me. Like, it's definitely not Phoenix Park. Come on.
And a disgrace to this country, and I hope the smell of our feet have left this house. And now that we're all up here in Aras An Uachtarain, I'd like to thank everyone for voting for me.
Anyone to carry Dustin over the threshold?
No, that's when you get married. And anyway, I'm not convinced about this place. I'm sure Aras An Uachtarain is in Phoenix Park.
Well, anyway, Aras An Uachtarain would have a very big door, and that's a very big door.
It's a very big door, it's a very big knocker.
Derek Davis would fit through that door.
He would, but I'm still not convinced. I'm not convinced at all.
No, this is it. Just I mean, you're trying to rain on my parade.
No, I would never rain on your parade.
7 years now I have been canvassing Hewlock and Derrindale, and now I finally get into the presidency. You're trying to ruin me mom with the glory.
Can I just tell people how we got here? Because yesterday...
Oh, that's a good idea, Mammy.
We were down in Corkway, and we got a phone call late in the evening to say that you'd become president. Which is a bit strange because the polling booths hadn't even closed at that stage.
What?
Some guy called Patrick De Valera or something, or Podge De Valera. Yeah, and he said, Aras is open, ready for you, ready for the new president.
He said, Aras is open and we are welcome to come in. That's what he said.
That was
very nice to Mammy Ray.
It was very nice. He gave us instructions and this is where we ended up.
This is Aras An Uachtarain here, Mrs. We're live outside Barry Robinson's. Hold on. I can smell the
can we visit the zoo soon?
Yes, we can visit the zoo. Actually,
I can smell our feet. She was definitely here.
We must be the right place then. Okay, well, I'll... Here goes.
Oh, yeah.
Brace yourself, Bias. We're going to be here for 7 years.
Well, at least we're not going to be broadcasting from the smelly shed.
But anyway, can we get a pool table?
Yes, I'm sure there's going to be plenty of room.
Can we get a jacuzzi?
Yes, we can get a jacuzzi. He's president, according to that guy, Project Devil.
Well, yeah, I don't know if there's going to anybody's going to answer.
No, you won't say again.
What says, Brace?
Someone coming, is there?
I think I hear footsteps.
Sam. Hello and welcome to Aras An Uachtarain.
Hello, Mr. Butler.
Hello, I'm the butler indeed, that is correct. And which one of you is Mr. Dustin, the new president?
That'd be me, Bob.
That's him.
The little one. Not you, not the big fella.
No.
Because you look like the tall fella, your man, what's his name, the old...
De Valera.
No, that's not...
Liam Neeson,
that's the one.
No, he
yeah, you're very welcome.
Can I just ask, this is Aras An Uachtarain?
Oh, it certainly is. It's a great pleasure.
He is the president.
Oh, yes, it's a great pleasure to have you here, El Presidente.
Do you have a fancy castle?
Well, yes, this is the Aras An Uachtarain hat.
No, it's just that I thought it was in Phoenix Park. I just thought we were in the place.
You're only dreaming.
I know, it's to do with the EU and the EC and all the malarkey. They changed it.
What?
Yeah. There was a lot of the zoo animals were getting in and eating people.
Oh, right.
Couldn't be happening. We lost five servants last year to the animals.
Come on in, you can.
You know the questions I asked you about Mary Robinson.
Come
join us on a great adventure. We've got room enough for everyone. You'll see lots of...
Never thought I'd see that.
This place is cool.
It's huge. I look at everything
I be able to put up posters in my room?
I don't think so, actually. We'll see. We might have to redecorate a bit.
We will. I've ordered four skips. Get rid of all this old rubbish. Boys, girls, posters, but I tell you what,
I think it's antique furniture.
What? Yeah, ancient it is, but I'll get rid of it all. Down to Atlantic Home Care, they've got good shelves down there.
No, I think that's the appeal of it. Like, people like antique furniture.
What? Could you imagine Boutrays, Galay, and Slavodan Milosevic coming to visit me up at the Aras, right?
Yeah.
And they arrive in the door and see all this old junk. You know what I mean?
No, they'll probably say that's wonderful, authentic antique furniture. That's what they'll probably say.
What?
Anyway.
What are you going to dress up as?
Well, I don't know. Yeah, what time will we be going trick-or-treating and all that?
That's important. You see, with all the presidential stuff, we've nearly forgotten all about it.
I'm president now.
Will you come out with us?
I'm not going to do what I did last year.
What are you going to dress up as?
He made me wear a dress last year. I'm not wearing a dress this year.
But that wasn't Halloween.
And anyway, you got more apples than anybody else.
Strangely enough.
So anyway, as I was saying...
Hello, Mr. Butler.
Hello. No, that's not my name.
What's your name, then?
Well, it is my name, but just call me Eamon.
Eamon the butler.
Yes, that'll do nicely, thank you. Anyway, this room has a lot of history.
Yeah, boss.
Yes, sir.
When are we going trick-or-treating?
Come here. Your presence.
No, Mr. President, there won't be trick-or-treating, though. We phenolphin all that kind of thing around this area.
You
what? We phenolphin all that kind of thing. It's not the done thing.
Well, we're going trick-or-treating and getting that jack of their money.
If you wanted to, your majesty, sir.
What are you going to dress up as?
If you wanted to trick-or-treat...
Hold on, Soky. I want to start this. What do you mean? What's the story about trick-or-treating?
Well, I'd like to explain. You see, in this area, of course, it's very refined and very posh and upper-classing. But you've got to make an appointment 3 months previous, and I didn't realise that you'd be into that kind of thing.
That doesn't make sense, does it? That's all the fun out of trick-or-treating.
I mean, obviously, there are one or two things you're going to have to give up when you're president, you know?
Yes.
Trick-or-treating's important, but I mean, at the end of the day, I mean, the money I'm be getting from the politicians into my back pocket,
Can I ask you a couple of questions?
Oh, certainly, sir,
I'm intrigued about the history. So, how many presidents have you served under?
70. Well, of course, there was the Douglas Hyde.
Mr. Butler, they must have been very heavy.
No, they didn't serve literally under them, no.
No, he
they
was
came
he...
one by one.
Yes.
So, Eamon, who was your favourite like, throughout the years?
Well, of course, there was two of the females. The two female presidents. There was President Hillary and President Mary Robinson.
I think it was
And then, of course, there was Sean T, President Sean T, who played an awful lot of golf.
Did he?
Lot of golf. He was hardly here for you know.
Mr. Butler, did he drink a lot of tea?
No, he just played golf, didn't drink tea at all.
Who's your favourite?
He's playing golf.
Yes. Whatever you said. Anyway, a De Valera, of course. He was a tall man, I used to call him. I don't mind saying, sir, but you, as a new president, certainly fill his boots very well.
Ooh. Not wearing anyone else's shoes. He was a statesman.
He was an historic figure, he was.
Oh, yes, he was historical.
Oh, I guess you're saying I'm not like, I look a bit like him.
No, not at all. Just that you'd be a fine president, I'm sure, and we're glad to have you here.
Well,
Eamon, I'd say after having a woman here for 7 years, any woman's welcome to come in.
Yes, indeed.
Would you be free to play Dunk the Apple?
Halloween, yes.
Oh, no, it's not the done thing hoi polloi around here, no.
And I wanted to ask you, Mr. Butler, what are you going to dress up as for Halloween?
No, you see, you're in the president's house now. It's all hoi polloi and phenomenal.
Eamon's dressed up as a butler.
Can I ask you a question?
Very droll.
Eamon, who would be planning Mr. President's itinerary and schedule over the next few weeks?
I'll be doing a lot of halting sites.
I'll be doing that, sir. It's my job as butler as well and personal secretary of His Majesty.
But that's what Lady Rose said.
Yes, that's what Lady Rose said. No. What I want to make sure is that you have 3 to 6 every day left free. You know, for then TV.
Mr. Butler, where are we going to put our camera?
No, you see, you are president now, Justin. There won't be time for any of that kind of, below the belt stuff.
But what about all the television and all that kind of thing?
Well, it's things that aren't important, really.
What do you mean? You know,
then
TV,
3 to 6, and... No, quite out of the question.
What do you say? Are you saying that he can't do then TV anymore?
He's going to be a very busy president indeed, and there won't be any time of that.
But you know what I mean, Bas? You know, like 3 to 6 network kills, top care kills,
all important.
Oh no, that's video. That's when you're signing the petitions. There's always kind of petitions and things to sign. And 3 to 6 is allocated,
right? Did you hear something? Is there somebody else?
No.
No, I definitely heard something.
Don't think that's anything.
Look, the chandelier shook.
No, nothing at all.
Listen, have a.
Where's
Eamon
the butler
guy? Have a look at this video.
Where'd he go?
Hey, wait a minute. You don't mean it, right?
Hey,
the sound must have come from down here, although the butler...
There would have been a modernising, that's all I said.
This place is cool. There's loads of places to play hide and seek.
There is no... It's mad. Look at me. Look at that for a range.
Range of what?
What are you doing in my kitchen? Get out before I shoot you.
What?
Get out! What are you doing in my kitchen?
No, wait, this is Dustin, the president.
I'm the new president of Ireland.
I'm so terribly old. My manners. Oh, I didn't. I wasn't expecting you. Should have made an appointment.
What?
I wasn't expecting you at all.
We were just.
Oh,
we were just oh, in admiring your range.
Were you?
Yes.
Very nice.
Yes, it's lovely, isn't it? It's the latest model.
How long have you been here now in Arsenal Front?
Oh, about 500 years.
What?
Anyway,
500 years?
Oh, yeah, I've been here toiling on my hands and knees, wearing my fingers down to the knuckles for all these presents that have come and gone.
What sort of duties would you have here every day?
I'll give you an idea of, and because I'm here all the time, you know that whole
what time do you get up and in the morning?
All you have to do is, as I was saying, all you have to do is ring any time and I'll be after service. Now, there's a couple of rules, right? I don't work between 9 and 6, right, in the evening, okay? And then I have a 5-minute break then after that. And then from 6:05 until 9, I'm not available because I'm on a computer course. And then after that, then I'll be dead. So you can get your own.
Well, I'm glad you're doing it. Computer courses, it's a very good idea nowadays.
What are you?
He's a sock monster.
I'm a sock monster.
Dustin's a sock monster. That's Dustin, and I'm right.
Well, I won't be cleaning up the hair after him.
No, he doesn't mow it at all.
Are you sure?
Positive.
Well, I won't be looking after it if you don't.
That's beyond the
call of my duty.
Maid, we brought in a dog with us. You didn't see him anywhere, did you?
A dog? Oh, lovely, because I have a pot just there on the range for him.
What?
No, I said... Did you call him Spot? Is that his name?
No,
his name is Duppy.
Duppy, I thought you said you had a pot for him, as if you were going to cook him or something.
Oh, no,
I'm not doing that.
Mrs. Maid. Mrs. Maid, you haven't seen a pig anywhere, have you?
Oh, are we having pork? I didn't know.
No, stop.
Don't mention that. Brenda Moyes, not to raise a pig down around the Daredale area. You know what I mean? Like, he could be calling over, so make sure there's no pork in the
menu. He's a little different to other pigs. He can speak.
Right, so if you're having a pig for a guest then, well, I'll put that in the newspapers, though.
Can I say that your mate upstairs never mentioned that there's anybody else in the house, because we heard a noise down here. And because he said there was nobody else in Aras, we thought, like, there must be something spooky going on.
There's no one else.
It was probably you, was it?
There is no one else. Yeah, it's just me and him.
Mrs. Maid, is there any ghosties or ghoulies in the house?
No, not many.
What do you mean, not many?
There's only a few. The ghosts and the rats.
You're only saying that. Just because it's Halloween and all that.
Well, it is Halloween. It's good fun, isn't it, to talk about ghosts and tell ghost stories and get dressed up and go out and trick or treat.
You'd never see a ghost in this house. Not before 9:00, anyway.
Listen, I tell you what, seeing as Dustin is
in
president,
I'm quite proud of you now.
Yeah, but I tell you.
Do you want to take our particular, food requirements? Because he doesn't eat like the normal president.
I don't, like butter boy. I eat all sorts of butter burgers with brown sauce and dead worms in them, right?
That's important.
I like them deep fried and cold fat. Don't turn the deep fat fryer on, right?
Tell her about the custard and the worms.
Oh, yeah, custard and worms, right. I want the worms alive in my custard. And I want them eaten on my custard, so I only put in small worms, because I hate when you bite the worm, the custard splats out all over. You know what I'm saying, boss?
It'll be porridge for tea, then.
That'll do.
Did you say porridge, Dusty?
There's something odd about
us. There's something very odd.
I tell you what, there's a nice bump.
Don't you think she looks a little bit like the butler?
You must be brother and sister, sir.
That's the way the gentry used to have it years ago.
Of course, in the family.
Family served.
And their fathers and mothers and their fathers will be before
them.
I tell you what,
grandchildren and their grandchildren will be in Aras, and I tell you what, we'll be the gentry and the nobles of the future.
Right.
It's about time that an honest politician was put into power with all those cowboys and crooks.
Dusty, I got a good idea. Why don't you do a speech to the nation later on?
Well, someone on the steps.
Yeah, but I might do one later on just to say thanks for voting for me.
In location. Yeah, very good, very
good. And you fools for believing everything I promised you.
I don't know if you can say that.
Right now, some Warner Brothers Halloween cartoons on NTV.
Mind you what's going on here.
What?
We've got a plan and we're going to stick to it.
Oh, there's a plan.
persuaded those two idiots and the big old smelly one to come over here. They think it's our Sinutra. But of course it's not our Sinutra.
It doesn't like our Sinutra.
And then we'll lock them away in a cupboard for 3 years.
Ah!
No, a cupboard. 30 years, let's make it.
And why don't we make it around 47?
47 it is. And we'll take over television and host Dead TV.
You know what?
Roger Pod, Dead TV.
Do you know what I think? I'd love to put Echo Island on, the Irish version, 5 days a week.
Brother of mine, it's a deal.
No competition. And any old drawings they send in, we'll rip them up.
Yeah,
and
we'll keep all the prizes for ourselves.
Yeah. And you know what else we'll do?
What?
Stall Santa's well again.
Oh. I have
you'd like to start to tell them that no children in Ireland need presents this year because they already have everything.
Yeah, they've enough.
Except for Podge and Rodge.
Oh, they've been awful good this year, haven't they?
Oh, Podge and Rodge have been so good, Santa. You can tell them lots of presents. And then when he comes down the chimney, we'll be waiting for him. I will give him the boot up the bottom.
A boot in the bottom.
I'll send him right back at the chimney and rob his sack for the toys.
I like it.
Oh,
but
I
look,
love it.
But look. Let's keep this plan going, Rog.
Okay.
They think it's our Sinutra. Dustin thinks he's the president. I don't know why he thinks people are nasty most.
What?
Oh, hold on.
Get lost. Here I am.
There you are. Did I hear voices? Were you talking to somebody?
No. Nobody.
I heard you talking.
You must have been just singing to yourself, are you?
No.
Happy in your work?
No.
Not at all?
No, that's
not a word.
Not at all, I'm working the
thing with you. Well, I was wondering if I could get a glass of milk, maybe, perhaps. Would that be okay?
Oh, of course it's okay, but why don't you get it yourself?
I thought you were the maid.
Okay. What?
That's your job, isn't it?
Well, I am the maid, but there's some things I don't do.
We're very...
Like cleaning and cooking, and traipsing around after you three idiots. I mean, of course, yeah. Oh, the milk is over there in the fridge. Yeah, I'll get it for you in a second.
And what about Dustin? It's great, isn't it, that he's president?
Oh, yes.
We're very proud. We're actually really proud of him, aren't we, Soky?
We are. He's the best.
And we were just wondering maybe...
He's going to be very busy from now on. Yeah, very, very, very busy.
Is
now.
He?
With all his
we're going to set up Den TV here at Aras An Uachtarain.
14 cameras, the whole lot.
Yeah, it's going to be really good. And we'll be on our show.
Yeah.
Well, we'll soon see about that.
Sorry?
Would you like a bit of brack?
The brack would be lovely,
yeah.
Brack
would be lovely.
I was just saying a cup of tea for the new president as well. Is that okay?
Yeah, kettle's over there. Get it.
Where about
you?
Over there.
What? Where'd the maid go, Mammy
Ray? Here we are. Listen, come out the break.
That's strange!
Soky, be careful on those stairs.
Be careful. If it's not Chappie as he's stood by me during the election, I tell you what, I'll be thanking everyone else who's stood by me during the
election. He loves it here, actually. And you know what you should do, actually?
What?
Do a formal thanks of, a speech of thanks.
I was actually thinking about that now.
You should get in there, right? Do you know the room we were in at the beginning?
Yeah.
And have a big presidential picture behind you, maybe Eamon de Valera, sit in your big chair, look down the camera and say, thank you, people of Ireland.
You're right, because, I mean, they gave me a bit of their heart every time they put an X in the voting slip. And I'd like to give them... Must be a bit of wind. But you're right, Ryan. But I have plans for Aras, you know what
it's
I mean?
It's not very presidential to be, you know.
Well, Mary Robinson did it all the time.
She did not do it all the time.
But I mean, like, I have plans for Aras. You won't recognise it, you know. I'm going to change the face.
What are you going to do?
Well, Quasar. Apparently, it's going to be big, you know, taking off. A mate of mine, Neil Kulak, got the contract for the South Dublin area, you know, the North Dublin area, so I might put one in. Taxi rank of cars, 24-hour bowling alley, Chinese restaurants in the left, and the Leo Bordos for the 50 eaters, you know what I mean?
I
so it's all going to change, you know. We're going to make the money and get out of here in 7 years and go and live in the Isle of Man. What's that? I tell you what, Soky's getting a bouncy castle. You will update the golf like you do every year anyway.
Thank you very much. And what sort of position will I have? Will I be your personal advisor?
Anyway, I'm going to say...
Stop doing that!
There you are now.
Where did you come from?
Eamon the butler, how are you?
I was upstairs. There's a bit of higgly poker, you know, trying to fix the stuff around the place. That's all I was doing. Doing my job. Yes, indeed.
Yeah.
Anyway, as I was telling you earlier about the former president, I mean, some of them wanted, I mean, that George Bush, when he was president of Ireland, he wanted to put in a bowling alley.
What?
Of course, I said that's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard. And, you know, taxi rag well, you want to put. No, no, taxi rag is out of the question, absolutely.
That's very hard.
The expenses and travel of the child is so expensive, it's just impossible.
Excuse me, Eamon, we were just talking about that. Were you
maybe you're right, actually. No, maybe Eamon has a point, because what do you need a taxi rag for more taxis on the road? Because, I mean, everyone should queue for 4 hours on a Friday night when it's really cold. I mean, they're right, you know, they own the roads.
And as for that other president, Booch's Galley, he wanted to put a Chinese restaurant in.
Was he president of Ireland?
Yes, he was.
He wasn't president of Ireland.
I say you've served under all the great presidents.
All 17 of them.
17.
Listen, we were planning a thank you speech from Aras.
That's impossible. It's absolutely impossible.
Well, no, just to thank the voters to put me into power, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, well, you can do it another day.
I want to fool them, make it look like they really care, you know, that sort of thing.
No need to rush into things, do it another day.
I want to do it while it's hot, you know.
I said no need to rush into things, do it another day.
No, there's no need to be like that. Can you recommend, because you've been here obviously longer than we have, can you recommend which is the most presidential looking room?
There's room with a rather large lock and key at the top floor. Well out of harm's way, and that would be nice.
So no one could walk in during the broadcast.
That's it exactly.
I wouldn't like the maid or yourself or maybe Soky or Snatter or Goopy.
I'll stand outside the door, close it over,
would
lock
you do that?
It, and lead us to it.
Eamon, we were hearing sort of strange.
I was upstairs all along.
Well, I must say, it's a point of health, you know.
Rugrats on MTV. Welcome back to Ben TV. Rugrats is great, isn't it?
It's great. Might be Rugrats 24 hours a day if I'm president. I can do what I want now.
Well, as I said, I am proud of you.
Well,
what do you think of this place, Soky?
I think it's really great, and there's loads of places to play hide and seek and play.
I tell you what, it's about time we got something. After being broadcasting from the basement, then a treehouse, then a caravan, then add insult to all injury. They put us in as many sheds down the back of the campus.
Actually, down a bit behind the bushes.
I tell you what, Soky, gone are the days when Hippo Head Davis blasted us, or Pat the Bar Kenny, or Telman the Granny Mansfield. Gave one all they ever asked him for his two tickets for the Late Late Show.
I never did anything on him. And he said no.
We've only met
the maid.
Bobby, will you fix my tie?
I will fix your tie, yeah.
Tony's the man for the brown corduroy, wasn't he?
Tony's
the man for the brown. I didn't think it looked good at first, but I'm here today.
I was running against four women, it's not as if I wasn't going to get elected. No, four women and your man.
Why did Benotti pull out in the end?
It was Mary Magalese, Mary Benotti, Eddie Rhodes, Dana, and Derek Nally.
The party invited everybody around and got a bouncy castle.
That's a good idea. I don't know if that Eamon guy's going to agree with it. I thought it'd be a better buzz. I thought there'd be more people around ours, like personal advisors, chauffeurs, gardeners. I thought there'd be loads of people. Yeah, it's just that Eamon and the maid.
Well, I suppose, I'll be taking on a couple of my own mates and had to get out here to come in here. What?
Do you think that the butler was a little bit fuzzy?
He was.
He seemed a little bit odd.
But I think when you work in a big house like this for all your life, you just get that way, you know.
I suppose he'd be fussy about it, you know.
Yeah, and
he possibly won't like the indoor go-karting track, you know. Some people don't like science, you know what I mean.
Dusty, what time will we change into our Halloween costumes at?
That's the thing. Eamon the butler said there's no trick-or-treating. He says it's a very hot residential area and you're not to be bothered.
Well, as you said already, when you become president of Ireland, you have to make some little sacrifices.
Yeah, I'm sure Christmas is...
we have to go out and trick.
That's the only problem. Like, it's great and I'm proud of you and all that sort of thing, but it's not really Halloween-y, is it?
It's not really. There's nothing...
Although I'm dressed up like a fool, I suppose.
Well, that's the norm for you. But I tell you what, it's a little bit... Well, not that I'm scared around them, but I'm just saying. Actually, there's...
Ooh. That was very loud, wasn't it?
Yeah.
What was that?
through them. We'd better go up and just have a look. Make
sure maybe there's more than just Eamon the butler and the maid.
Commercial break on Den TV.
Yeah, check it out.
Everything's in order up here. It sounded like it was coming from here.
Four flights of stairs, I tell you, I'm going to have to get the net elevator in here.
Well, I don't think it really suits the house, would it?
Yeah, everything doesn't suit, sir. You know what I mean?
Dusty, you know what we could do? We could put goals down at that end and goals back at that end, and we could have a football.
I don't think that'd be allowed in Aras An Uachtarain.
Well, I thought I owned it. You know, I've planned for this guy.
Well, I know I've been saying it, but I'm not comfortable here. I'm just not comfortable. Maybe it's because you're the president and I'm not. Maybe that's why I don't feel comfortable. It's just,
yeah, but
it's
hold just on, lads. Like I said, I'm going to look after you, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, it's no problem there, you know. Don't worry about it. Whatever name the butler says, you know. You're me right-hand man, you know. Like two chicken tin and all that, you know.
He's strange as well, and that maid is strange. The whole thing is strange. I feel...
Well, when I pull up a couple of me Spice Girls posters and all that sort of stuff, a couple of boys now.
But I'm sure they won't let you, will you see?
Yeah, but well, I thought they'd be allowed to do it one time. President tries to be allowed to do it at once.
But are you really happy that you're present? Because, you know, usually Halloween, Soky and I trick or treating, out and about.
But obviously, lads, you're going to have to give up the odd small thing, you know, when you're president.
I suppose.
I mean, maybe, you know, like maybe Christmas will be twice as good as it normally is, you know. Easter Bunny might come twice a year, you
well, maybe,
know.
Maybe if we just get a plate of nuts or something, you know, just for Halloween. Just to make it seem like,
Yeah, but don't drop the shells in the carpet because they will go mad.
Ooh, you're getting very posh.
Well, no, I'm just like,
well, this is, look at this, this is posh. Listen, swear.
Well, what do you want? I'm very busy altogether. Service at all.
That was very quick.
How'd you do that?
What?
Four flights of stairs. I just rang and you just like that.
Oh, sure. I've been very light on my heels. That's all. That's
you're
all
a bit of a Sonny Al Sullivan. You haven't got bad legs either.
Anyway, can I be in service?
Yeah, you know, we were just trying to get a bit of a Halloween atmosphere going. You know, some nuts and bit of fruit, apples and stuff.
Do you have any apples you want to pay Doug the apple?
No.
Sorry, what's your name again?
In Japan.
In Japan.
Well, made in Japan. Could I have a quick word with you here? What's the you knock off it? You know what I mean?
What?
You know what I mean?
What are you doing about it?
You mean, oh, no, I'm here 26 hours a day, 12 weeks a year. Oh, yes, indeed. No, I never get a break at all. No, we're here to serve all the time.
Soky, look at it. Look at the maid there.
What?
Have a good look at her.
You know what?
Who does she remind you?
She looks very like Eamon the butler.
The spitting image.
Oh, we're not really ages at all. No. That's purely coincidental.
And you have the same sort of accent. Where's that accent from? Cavan, is it?
No. It's Ballygoblet. That's where I'm from, Ballygoblet. And he's from Abbey Gobsheen. He's from, completely different place altogether. Oh, the
opposite
end of the world.
I've never been there.
Yeah, no, just turn there.
What?
Yeah, there, look at the profile.
You look very like the butler, I have to
say. Excuse me, in Japan, what are you going to be dressing up for Halloween?
Oh, I've no time for that. No, we're not allowed, dress up at all for Halloween.
Well, are we allowed in any form?
No, quite frankly, no, I don't think so.
Well, everybody is fun at Halloween. Everybody is fun every day.
Well, now that Justin is in presidential office, there'll be no time for any of that malarkey. No time for any fun at all.
Well,
absolutely no blooming way!
Will we be able to show boys and girls drawings and birthday photographs?
Good point.
And play birthday music.
Well,
and,
I suppose if you must. But it might be frowned upon.
Well, I tell you what. The secret world of Alex Mack.
Right, I've got to go and lock the toilet.
I'm not, it's weird, isn't it? It's weird.
There's something wrong.
Anybody for a song?
The wheels on the bus go round and round. Do you know it, Bobby?
Okay, I'll give you a note here. How's that?
The wheels on the bus go round and round.
And even the butler doesn't like us touching anything, you know.
I tell you what, fun is not in his name.
Well, you know, I saw when you're president, you know, you have the Irish football team or the owner of the Spice Girls.
Well, Mary Robinson did. She never had the Spice Girls around, mind you. But she had the Irish football team.
Looks like I'm going to bring no one over. And he may hatch it because he has a criminal record. He's not allowed to visit.
No, he wouldn't be. And what about your schedule, like? What was he saying? There's a 4 o'clock, and then a 5 o'clock, and then a 6 o'clock.
Don't forget the half hour. Have no time to do dead TV.
Wait a minute. There's no way I'm not watching programs like The Secret Wire of the Manic Man. You know
Halloween
I mean?
Special. Halloween special.
Yeah.
Remember that. Do you think Barry Robinson had time to watch The Secret World of Alex Mack?
Probably watched it the odd time at Aubrey.
Yeah. Because remember Mary was in with us.
She was.
Former president. I'm the new president now, but former president Mary Robinson, she was telling us all her favorite cartoons and that she's
That's
never
right.
missed Tiny Toons and all these sort of stuff. Wonder where she got the time to watch them.
Do you know when you're in some place and you just get a sort of an eerie shiver
I mean,
down your back?
Yeah, like cabin. It seems really cold in here, doesn't
Not
it?
Not like cabin, no. You know, as if there's... And it always seems as if there's somebody...
Mammy Ray, do you mean there might be ghosties here?
There could be. Perfect day for them, Halloween.
Ghosties and the ghoulies.
In Aras An Uachtarain. And he's a dickish outfit as well.
Yeah, Tony from Wardrobe. I mean, I'm going to have him sacked now that I'm president. I look the fool all week going around the country, you know. Wednesday I look like...
Look at us, we look like three pig farmers.
Huh?
We are the men in brown.
Mammy Ray, don't say that to Spotter.
But Tony no. said the brown's the next black. That's what he said.
He knows all that sort of thing, doesn't he?
Well, Mammy never Ray, said Tony's been wearing corduroy since before I was born.
Yeah, he has.
He's wearing it since 1978. He says he has a pair of World Cup jocks with Argentina on. He hasn't taken them off since.
That's not true
but
either.
See, I thought he said you were supposed to keep that quiet.
You know what it is? Look, it's going up to 5 o'clock.
I tell you what,
how
I mean,
about
Mammy Ray, all the other boys and girls will be going out trick or treating. What are we going to do?
Yeah, I know.
Here's
yeah.
another point, right?
Yes.
Right. How come there's no smell of feet in here? If Mary Robinson lived here for 7 years, the woman stank. Her feet were disgusting.
She didn't. And you've been putting that rumor about. And constantly I'm saying, no, Mary Robinson's
feet.
And
I've been looking
smell.
For traces of Nick's beard as well.
Yeah.
Her husband.
No, what I was going to say is, right, it's going up to 5 o'clock. How about we find a television, watch the 5 o'clock news, get the good news, you know.
I'd rather watch Den TV, no way.
Well,
no, but no.
Though we'll get to see you on the news.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah.
But you can imagine, you know.
Right,
watch this. Good evening, welcome along to the news. Dustin Hoffman has been voted in the 8th president of Ireland.
I know what you mean, Dusty. Hey. I know who's reading the news
I
tonight.
I like that. No, he's got a point, Soky.
It's Mammy Ray's favourite babysitter, Anne Casson.
No, that's nothing
she
to do with it.
She does the 5 o'clock, doesn't she?
Yeah, well, she might do. But no,
well,
I'm
no, not. You're right, Ray. I'll be cool to hear. The 8th president of Ireland, Dustin the Turkey, has been voted in and went to Aras An Uachtarain today where he took up his position.
Wouldn't it be good?
Yeah, well, that's
Mammy
that
Ray,
when
they say
it's
that we're not able
moment.
To hang posters on the wall in our bedrooms and we're not allowed to friends with, and yeah. we don't
have
time
to do
TV.
Fire. We yes. won't tolerate. We're the next president. He's only aiming the butler and made in Japan. So, sounds funny like that, doesn't it? But I'm going to go and I'm going to start it out. You know what I mean?
Right, you do
I'm
that.
Not gonna
have we have
that
to find a television
anyway.
Listen, commercial break. We're going to have to look for a television show to see the 5 o'clock news.
Together and what do you get? The big, big load of construction said, load it up, chug along, dump it out. Big, big loader, big, big loader works all day long. So I sing this big, big song, load it up, chug along, dump it out. Big, big loader, load it up, chug along, dump it out. Big, big loader, just told me to think of it.
I don't want you to work all day, but I want you to be true, and I just want to make love to you, love to you.
Your Princess Barbie in your sparkly crystal dress.
You can make our dreams come true.
Magical princess.
New Juicy Gums. They're soft and they're chewy. Aww.
But it's because they're made with real fruit that Juicy Gums are so juicy. New Juicy Gums from Opal Fruits in five fruity flavors.
That gum, as you say.
Some people like their hair to just stay still. I want mine to move. The actual freedom of dance is lovely. My hair is all part of the movement. Rehearsals every morning, performance every evening. Wash and go is great because actually when I've used it, I can run my fingers through my hair completely.
Wash and Go contains a conditioning system that smooths and separates each hair strand.
And I love the way it moves. It's definitely possible for hair to dance.
People on the go, wash and go.
I like to wash my hair and I like to go.
Interested in a perfect people carrier with great gas mileage that's good for the earth?
Well, interest on this, pal. Ricochet, virtually unstoppable in total twin body technology, lets Ricochet do punishing, pulverizing stunts and hit the ground running every time. Big pump-up tires, big 9.6 volt power for really big stunts. Ricochet, drive it like you hate it.
Oh, Sunday bikers.
Right, we'll show them. Let's go!
This way, Tony.
Awesome.
You've beaten the best, but nothing beats the great taste of Kellogg's Frosties. They're part of a better breakfast. Kellogg's Frosties. Enough to bring out the tiger in you. They are great!
Boyzone magazine out now.
It's only words.
It's more than words with the hottest gossip. The inside stories, fun competitions, great prizes, and more. Boyzone magazine. Get your copy today. Boyzone magazine out now.
Rayo, Soky, there you are.
Oh, you found a TV?
Yeah, I found one. Can you believe, right? So that is the only television in Aras An Uachtarain. One of the biggest houses in the world.
You think the president would want to be seeing, you know, Euro News and all that sort of thing, just to keep in touch with what's going on in the rest of the world?
Do you think we should be in it?
Yeah, because it says it's do not enter on the door.
Yeah, I saw that as well. You know what else, right? Why are there all bars in the windows in some of the rooms? And another thing, right? Where is Guppy gone? And besides that being the only television here, there's no telephones either. Or radio.
Maybe that's the way it is. It's probably a place where the president comes to relax.
That's supposed to be it.
You know, and you don't want to be, people ringing you and watching telly and stuff like that.
Dusty, maybe you shouldn't watch the telly because they might be planning some sort of surprise party.
No, we have to watch the telly because you know, Soky knows, and I know that you're the president.
Yeah,
but have you seen it on the news?
I think when
really
the lads win
through
the All-Ireland, they want to go back and see the game live. All the hurlers would still be watching it, and they'd be watching how they played and all that. Thanks a million for making me the 8th president
the
of
news,
Ireland.
The newsreader come on the weekend. And
I hope it's Brian Dobson. I love him.
Well, you know who my favourite is.
Well, your one-hand eye looks like a bit like an elephant nowadays.
Oh, that's not very nice.
No, he does. Mammy Wade's favourite is Anne Catherine.
You love her.
Yeah, she usually does the
our
private talk show.
Why don't you love Sharony Boylan? She's not going on, you good thing. She's all right looking, isn't she? She's not a bad looking board, what? Yeah, well, she's down the pigeon club, I tell you, the lads talk about her non-stop.
Sorry?
Non-stop.
Oh, they talk about her non-stop.
34B. That's the bus she gets in. Thanks for making me the 8th president of Ireland.
Anyway, whether it's Sharon or Brian or Anne or Eileen or whoever.
I'm too excited. Let's turn the telly on.
It's okay, okay.
What's her name? You don't like her at all.
Una who?
That's what everyone else says. No one knows her. What's her name?
Una Slappy.
That's the one you said you don't like. Right.
I never said that. Anyway, they'll be coming on the go.
Thanks for making me the
8th president of
Ireland.
Congratulations to Dustin. He's the 8th president of Ireland.
But anyway, I feel all funny like I've got little butterflies in my tummy.
Yeah, well, it's an historic moment.
Yeah.
Will you turn it on then?
What's wrong with it? Don't do that!
What are you doing in here?
We just want to watch the news.
Did you not see the sign on the door? It says, get out!
No, it says, do not enter, actually.
Yeah, it says that as well, but the small print underneath it says, besides the picture of the name, it says, get out!
Get out!
What are you doing in here? It's private property!
But made in China.
No, it's made in Japan.
Oh! Japan. I'm sorry, but I mean, like, we were just going to watch a bit of telly, you know, see about me becoming the president. And I thought as vice president, I'd be able to go anywhere in the Aras An Uachtarain.
Yeah, well, listen to me, Turkey Bread. You can't watch yourself on this television because this television is an antique. It was invented before electricity, right? So it doesn't work. But, they can all get lost.
No, surely it must work, it's a...
excuse me, mate, it's a pat. Excuse me, mate, it's a pat. You know what it
was? Don't insult my little brother, Rui. I'll have you for dinner. Rui.
I do.
No. Stop.
I'm on you.
I do the cooking round here.
Go and have a go if you think you're good enough, Rui.
I do the cooking
round
here.
Sorry about this.
We'll put you in jail, Rui. I'm on you.
Sorry.
And I mean it.
That's not very presidential behavior.
Sorry
about that.
I was just about to ask Lady Japan if it was plugged in, would it work? Fuck, it's plugged out!
Socky, go over and plug it in.
No, don't touch that. I wouldn't do that at all.
Ah, that's it, we have something there.
Well, we have something there.
We've missed the five o'clock. We get the half five. You watch Echo Island and we watch the half five.
We're about to stick around for that.
Where's Mate Japan gone?
Have a wonderful ball of fun day. I don't think it's your day to trouble tonight, but dress up and get loads of trick and treats. Have a good time. See you next week. Ah, where were we? Oh, yes, we're dancing.
Isn't that class? It's one of those proud moments where I'd like to say, V May, a Queen of Air Image Palace Downing, August V to a student in Madras, the Gihon Lair, Gokla, August V May, Artist.
Mummy Ram, what's Dustin saying?
It doesn't make any sense. He said something about thinking about playing
football. One of my first presidential duties, I'd like to declare war on Azerbaijan. They won't fire a shamrock, we'll fire the missiles.
No, I don't think you did that sort of thing.
As president of Ireland, you should be a symbol of peace. Wow. Not declaring war.
She tried to stop war.
It's been a very strange day for us. It hasn't been a Halloween day, really.
Who we met, yeah. I wanted to go trick-or-treating, but because I'm president of Ireland, I can't now.
We'll go trick-or-treating.
Well, Eamon the Butler, who we met. We met Eamon the Butler. He said we can't. And then we met Maid in Japan. That's the main.
What was her name, Maid Marian?
Did you think that she didn't want us to watch the telly?
Yeah, well, I got that impression.
Yeah.
Maybe she was warning us. I mean, you know, John Creedon's on RT1 at the moment doing that review of the week thing.
Yeah, fair enough.
I mean, but she's supposed to be trying to help us there. But what's strange is that that's the only telly in Aras An Uachtarain. There's no radio or telephone. And there's lots of bars all over the window.
Oh, it's going to be exciting. The official news is that Justin is the president of Ireland.
Five of his prime doctors.
Anne Castle. It is Anne Castle.
Congratulations for the president-elect have come in from all over the world.
Yeah,
after the inauguration, she'll be moving into Aras An Uachtarain to become the eighth president of Ireland. Of the other presidential candidates, Dustin the Turkey polled poorest. He failed to even get 1% of the vote. Actually, he was Paddy last. Huh? Another news now, reports are coming in that Jack and Gail are now finally down off the hill.
That must be a mistake.
Mammy Ray, it's that. That's RTE, and that's Anne Cassin, and she was reading the news.
She says what it is. She does.
But usually.
So, if you're not president, and this isn't all it's looking for.
Is anyone going to smell a scent of man?
There's mist at the foot here, lad. Sorry about that. Commercial break. I know who's behind all this.
Poor.
1% of the vote. Actually, he was Paddy last.
Yeah. Paddy last. Yeah, why did I ever think I'd be president? It's a joke. I wonder even people like Pat Kenny laugh at me. Great. Who'd want me to be president anyway? Couldn't even win against five women.
Actually, he was Paddy Laugh.
Paddy Laugh.
He was Paddy Laugh. He was Paddy Laugh.
Who's that?
That's where you are. Are you okay?
Dusty, we were worried about you.
I thought I was going to be president.
Well, everybody thought
you were
going to be president.
Well, Dusty, we thought you were too.
And whoever made us think that you were president, that's a very mean thing to do.
Yeah, I was looking forward.
It's dishonor.
It is dishonor.
Looking forward to dressing up for Halloween and going out trick or treating.
But Dusty,
instead of wearing
we
a brown corduroy
can.
Suit in some place that isn't ours to nuke them on.
Definitely not ours to nuke them. I told you from the start. I don't want to say I told you so, but I told you so. When we arrived here, I said, this is not Aras An Uachtarain. You heard me say it.
Aras An Uachtarain's in Phoenix Park. I wanted to get in and be president. I didn't care where it was.
Yeah, well, it's strange when you think you've, you know, achieved something, you're sort of blind.
Why anyway did the butler fool us and the maid fool us?
Well, that's why, you see, I think...
Sorry,
I think the butler and the maid aren't what they seem.
Sorry, that's said the man.
He's
getting up me beak.
Yeah, you're allergic to that, aren't you?
Well, I wonder who wears scent of man.
Well, let's just recap on what happened here.
Ray does. Ray, your mum wears it as well.
It all started yesterday evening when we got a... My mother does not wear it. We got a phone call.
Only after she shaves.
Excuse me, my mother does not shave.
She doesn't shave.
Yeah, well, she doesn't. She has a beard.
Well, anyway, what are we going to do?
This is not a time to be slagging my mother off. I tell you, just let's recap and see what... Let's piece things together here. Because it's like a jigsaw puzzle. We got a phone call yesterday evening from a Padraig De Valera.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Eamon's father.
Well, that's what he said. Yeah. Now, he couldn't be Eamon's father.
Ah, no, because his great-grandfather phoned back, Ronald De Valera.
Yeah,
well,
you see, aren't we silly?
What?
Eamon De Valera has been dead for years, so his father must be dead. And his grandfather definitely dead.
Yeah, so
it obviously wasn't the real McCoy. He was somebody playing a prank. Huh? And they gave us the directions to come here, saying it was Aras An Uachtarain.
Like that time someone called Dickie Bow phoned up.
When we knocked on the door and the door opened, Eamon the butler said, he said, welcome to Aras An Uachtarain.
Now there's another thing, Eamon the butler.
Yeah?
Eamon, I just remember it there. Yeah, no, there was this guy who was on television years ago in a poem called Whispering Spare, and his name was the butler, Eamon the butler.
Yeah?
So that's not a real name.
So that's what he's doing now.
No, that's just a makey up name. Eamon the butler,
I hope Eamon the butler doesn't mind him using it.
I doubt if he does. Anyway,
it's made in Japan.
Yeah, in Japan. Have you ever heard a name like in Japan before?
She said it's an Irish name.
Yeah, but
she also said her name is Maid Marian.
But you don't see it made in Japan. Like a toy or something made in Japan, or a shirt made in Japan.
Oh, I see what you mean. That's in Tokyo.
So they're not all the same.
Who do you think made in Japan?
Well,
who would
like to ruin our Halloween?
And why don't they have a television or radio or telephone?
And why isn't there anybody else here? I'll tell you why. Two words here, actually three, because there's an and in the middle.
Hmm?
Podge and Rod.
Podge and Rod.
You know what? It makes sense now. They want us to take over Den TV, I bet you, and replace it with rubbish programs.
And it suits them to have
in
an Aras An Uachtarain that isn't an Aras An Uachtarain for 7 years while they're broadcasting.
Well, I mean,
all
here we are missing Halloween wearing brown corduroy suits. Let's
come
get
here.
It.
I got an idea.
Yeah, let's give them a real Halloween
scare. Ah, let's give them a taste of their own medicine. That's a very good idea, Soky.
Yeah.
We're going to scare the living daylight out of Podge
and
Rodge.
Make sure you don't miss it. They're going to get their come up.
Pop
scene.
So you just up to go.
It's Dublin's busking elite and survives to tell the story. We also have new music from the Spice Girls, Sheryl Crow and Peter Andre. But right now, it's the Great Western Squares.
Turn the clock back.
About to go out trick or treating, but we need something to do first.
Something very important to do, actually. Just in case you're tuned in, it's a sort of a long, complicated story, but I'll just do it very quickly.
Well, anyway, start at the start.
Well, we got a phone call from Podrick De Valera, and he was Eamon De Valera's dad, but then he must be dead, so it couldn't have been him. Anyway, we got a phone call, and it told us to come here to Aras An Uachtarain, but it's not Aras An Uachtarain, because Aras An Uachtarain is in Phoenix Park and is in the middle of the city. No. Anyway, we thought it was Aras An Uachtarain, and then there was Eamon the butler. He was the butler, obviously, and then there was Maid in Japan. And they were acting very strangely, and we thought that Dustin was present, but he wasn't actually present, because on the 5:30 news, Anne Catherine got on and said he was Paddy Lass. He was very upset, and then we started thinking, well, maybe Eamon the butler and Maid in Japan weren't exactly what they thought they were, or we
and
thought they were.
All of a sudden, there was a smell of sense of man.
So, we copped on it with Podge and Rodge. They were up to their old tricks again, so we decided we'd have to sort them out and scare the living daylights out of them, and that's why we're dressed like this, because we're going to scare the living daylights out of them.
Are you sure this is spooky enough?
Well, let's try our wounds.
Do I look silly?
Yeah. Hey, put it on.
Wow. You see, we're supposed to look scary.
Hey, Rael, you look just like your mother. Well, your mummy anyway.
I was going to say you look like mummy right now, Bobby. Right?
Okay, well, let's see if we're scary. Let's do our best scary bit then.
Right,
okay?
Here we go.
I'm a big, scary sock, my heart.
Soky.
I'm a ghost.
Soky.
Oh, yeah.
Boom.
Hey, hold on, let's try one. Take it off, Rael.
How did I know he was going to do that? Look, we've no time for fun and bollocks now.
Will you fix my sock?
Sorry?
Will you fix my sock?
Right, I tell you what, Podge and Rodge are going to get one Halloween scare they're never going to forget.
They're going to get their comeuppance.
Well,
okay,
Bobby,
the plan is, right, I ring the bell, they come up here, can't answer the bell, we hide, and then we jump out.
And anyway, when you ring the bell, where does the bell ring?
Down in the basement, the scullery, in the kitchen, where they are.
Who are you?
Okay.
Right, I will hide everyone. I'm going to get them a big scare.
Well, I could have heard it too, but...
Where are those idiots?
Dunno.
Look, we've got to lock them away soon, right? We've got to take over Dead TV, and it'll be ours forever.
Yeah.
And they'll be locked away. I can't believe that Dustin actually thought that he had been voted as president.
I know. I can't wait to lock them away.
They're awful idiots.
Oh, they're total idiots. Total galoots. And total gobbler-loobies.
When you said earlier that these are ghosts, in the house today, because Halloween is very clever, very droll.
Yeah, as long as they're not really our ghosts.
Oh, don't be stupid. Look,
I wouldn't be too happy if they were ghosts.
You've got to...
Let's do it again.
No, that
wasn't.
No, that's
you sure?
No, it wasn't.
What was that? What was that? It couldn't be.
Lying down. Let's go around Fox Rock. I hear they're loaded there. They might give us some BMW.
Dusty, this has been the best Halloween ever.
Yeah, I don't need to be president when I have great friends like
you. And you know what, Dusty? Aww. I like being in our shed.
Listen, we see you tomorrow back in the shed, the smelly shed. It's better than this place, anyway.
What? We on tomorrow?
I like the smelly shed.
No, we're not actually tomorrow Saturday. Yeah. See you on Monday. I'll see you on Monday.
Have a great Halloween.